Hello friends, let's begin with case study based on modeling and analysis of structural parts. In this module, we are going to learn the basic of static analysis or structural analysis, and then we check out some of the case studies which are based on the structural parts. So let's begin with this. Static analysis. So equation of static analysis will be force is equal to K, that is stiffness matrix or stiffness property of element, and D will be the displacement, which is usually unknown. Okay. So in this static analysis, the load or field conditions do not vary with respect to time. So remember that static analysis means the whatever time domain analysis are there, that is df by dt will be 0. It is a straight line. Okay. So remember this. And therefore it is assumed that there is a load and field conditions applied gradually, not suddenly. So load will be acting, that is force will be acting, that is gradually, not suddenly force is acting. Okay. And the system under this analysis can be linear one and non-linear. And the inertia and damping effects are ignored in a static analysis. So that the above this equation is called a force balance equation for a line system. And if the elements of the matrix K are the function of X or function of displacement D, the system is known as nonlinear system. And nonlinear system includes large deformation, plasticity, creep, and so on. Okay, so those things also we will check in further slides. So, if whatever the static analysis is do to formulate the first stiffness matrix for a given shape, then it will do the meshing of that part either in one dimension, two dimension, or three dimension. Then we apply the load condition. That is, we are applying the support condition. For example, let's consider a cantilever beam. So everybody knows that how cantilever beam is there. So this is our cantilever beam. Okay. So this is in 1D, and in cantilever beam, everybody knows that we have to apply the load at a one end, and one end is fixed. So this is a nothing but support condition, where at this particular location displacement will be 0. Okay, so at this particular location it will be 0 while force is here. Okay, so whatever the force and deflection we are getting here, so that is in particular direction like this, and we are finding out the deflection at the tip or at the free end. So we are finding out the deflection at the free end. So that deflection we are calculated by using either our analytical method or by using a static analysis, or F is equal to KD. Okay. So here what we do, we find out stiffness matrix. So for that purpose, we have to split into two elements, line elements 1 and 2, or we can take a 3, 4, 5, it depends upon you. And then we solve the equation by direct method or other methods, variational methods or Galerkin method, and after that we find out first displacement. So every time we have to find out the displacement at the free end first, then only we can get a stress value and strain value. Okay, so that is a linear static analysis. In static analysis, if you observe that there is a stress strain curve. Okay, for linear static analysis, what is that? Sigma is proportional to epsilon. So this first part is sigma is proportional to epsilon. That means stress is proportional to strain. It is a linear curve. This linear curve represents that it's a elastic limit, that is stress and strain are proportionally going in the same path. That means whenever you apply the load condition, that time the strain and stress proportionally increases. Okay, so that is a linear static analysis. While in case of non-linearity, what is actually happen in non-linearity, that will come into the plastic region. Okay, that means as like our rubber, when we stretch a rubber at a particular limit, after that proportional limit, it will become, it will not regain its original shape. So that means it's a plastic region or non-linear region. So that time what will happen is a geometric. In geometry, they are having a large deformation. While material is beyond elastic limit when it E is in metal, and within elastic limit when E is in non-metal, that is shown in this figure. While creep, that is a progressive deformation of a material at a constant stress, that means for long time process, and contact, gap elements and contact. That is shown in our gear mechanism. So, gear mechanism, any type of spur, bevel, then helical, everywhere we get a contact or gap element. So, that is also we learn in the gap elimination on contact simulation. While material non-linearity is very important. In case of non-metal, the stress strain curve will be like this. In case of metal, the stress strain curve will be like this. After metallic property, it will go to the plastic region, while in non-metal, it is continuously going in a plastic region or elastic region. Okay. So, the graphs are like this. Now, the most of the cases, static analysis is divided into these types. Okay. Linear analysis, as we already gone through cantilever beam analysis, then non-linear analysis, then leakage analysis and buckling analysis. Buckling analysis can be separated from static also, or it can be included in the static analysis also. It depends on the perspective of a APA programmer or APA solver. Okay. So, if you consider that linear analysis is a limited range, we are solving only 1D problem or most of the cases in linear analysis or axisymmetric analysis where we are applying the load at the one end and one end is fixed. Okay. So we are just finding out a simple analysis or linear analysis. While all the structural buildings are done, as beam and another construction part, those are comes under linear analysis. Okay. And then it will come under modal analysis. So linear analysis is that part. While non-linear analysis is having contact non-linearity, material non-linearity and geometric non-linearity as we discussed before. So, first going to linear analysis, suppose this is our pressure vessel or this is a pressure vessel having a hydrostatic pressure is applied along the circumference of the vessel and the both the ends or supports are fixed and we have to check how much is the maximum pressure it will carry. Okay, so that is consider that means how much displacement will be taken place at which end and how much pressure is applied inside the this pressure vessel. So that pressure is calculated from one mass stress analysis plot. And here, if we get a different type of simulation, that means the maximum stress is in red color. It's shown is 0.0304 maximum in megapascal. Okay, while minimum is nothing but zero. Okay, for particular time second, we are calculated this hydrostatic pressure analysis or how much load carrying capacity of the pressure vessel in static condition. Okay, then a non-linear analysis, as we know, the material non-linearity. So material non-linearity means this curve. As the stress strain curve changes with respect to different types of material, nowadays composites are coming, different types of high strength alloys are there, different types of machining conditions are there. So, at a different range of all the varieties of material, non-linearity will be taken place. And when the non-linearity is having isotropic or anisotropic or some another type of material properties, that time we get the non-linear curve, that is a, it comes under plastic zone or there is a material nonlinearity due to that, we get a convergence analysis. Okay. Then contact nonlinearity, that means whenever there is a contact, forces are there. So before going to contact, we just go for the geometric nonlinearity. For example, we get the large deformation. Okay. When we get a nonlinear analysis, large deformation, let us consider a spring that is fixed at this end. This blue color is shown in that. It is a fixed end, and we applied a force on this red side on particular x direction, suppose, okay, or y direction. So that force, when we apply it, there will be a large deflection within the spring, and that is a nonlinear geometric nonlinearity. Okay. So when we go to contact nonlinearity, for example, this is our particular flange. It's having bolt, nut bolt connections, and bolt connection is having a particular gasket. So now we have to select the gasket analysis. Contact nonlinearity is depend on our gear analysis. While leakage analysis is having this flange, and flange is having different nut bolt tolerance, or this bolt clearance will be fixed here, or we are giving the strength to the particular analysis. Now, when we go to the total deformation of this particular cutted section or one section of a flange, there, that is because of its axis symmetry. Okay. So, we get the red zone at this particular end, that is maximum deformation will be occurred there, and nut bolt failures will be there. If it is a nonlinear gasket, that time there is having a different pressure level and closure, that is loading and unloading curve will be like this. So there are two terms are there, pressure and closure. So according to the pressure and closure, loading curve and unloading curve, the type of nonlinearity will be taking place in the gasket. Okay, so this is the one of the type of nonlinear curve which is observed in a leakage analysis. While buckling analysis, there is a linear buckling and nonlinear buckling. Buckling analysis takes place as per the basis of compressive load. How much the compressive load is acting accordingly at the center of, at the center it will get deflected at the one of the end, but at the center there will be a strength or a maximum stress will be accumulated. It is the only deformation analysis of the compressive load. Okay, so that is can be linear buckling and non-linear buckling will be taken. Hope you understand very well. These are the taken from graph engineering. You can easy to understand from graph engineering also. Thank you so much. Hope you understand very well.